Most of you will be aware now of the crystal automatic chemical dosing systems that we do, and in another video we covered the domestic probes that we use. We're now going to look at the commercial probe, which is a free chlorine amperometric probe. The system itself would normally use the same pH probes as in the previous video. The amperometric probe comes packed in a box and it is a delicate electronic instrument and it should be treated as such. So we'll just unpack it. It comes with a full operating instructions, which must be followed to the letter. You get a cable if you need a spare cable with an M12 connector. Set of rubber gloves that should be worn when you're putting in the electrolyte gel. The electrolyte gel itself, the probe, and the filler cap that goes with the gel. The amperometric probe itself comes with a protective cap on the end and a silicon band around the outside, which you can see we've already pulled down, and it exposes a little weep hole in the side of the cap. This must be removed before you do anything with the cap, either taking it on or off. This relieves the pressure inside the end cap, and if you don't have that hole exposed, you'll blow a hole in the little membrane at the end, and that's damaged forever then. So you carefully unscrew the probe, and if you're just checking it for calibration or anything, make sure the probe is nice and clean and tidy, it's got no corrosion. If it's marked or corroded in any way, it should be returned to be refurbished. You then, with the cap in your hand and your gloves on, use the electrolyte gel with the filler cap to fill the cap up. And there must be no air bubbles in this, so it's good practice to store this gel upside down because it's quite thick. And you then squeeze it into the cap very, very gently, very slowly, making sure there is no trapped air inside the cap. When you get to the bottom of the threads, that should be enough gel in there now. The reverse procedure, of course, is you screw the cap back on. And when you're screwing this cap on, you will see the excess gel come out the weep hole. This operation of screwing this cap on should take 5 minutes. If you do it any quicker, you're doing it too quick, and you could again blow a hole in that membrane cap. So you have to do it very slowly, letting the excess come out that weep hole. Once you get to the end of the seal, you'll hear it's tight. You can feel it's tight now and locked home firmly. Then you pull the silicon band back over to cover the weep hole up. The probe is then inserted into the flow cell. It should be left powered up and with the water flowing over it for 6 hours before you start looking at any calibration of it at all, if it is required. It takes a good 6 hours to come up to working temperature. If you do damage the cap or you do maintenance on these systems, the electrolyte gel and the caps are available as a spare part. So this is a free chlorine probe. It will measure the actual chlorine in the water, so you will get a parts per million reading on the screen of your controller. Unlike the redox probe, which was just measuring the potential of the water, this measures the actual chlorine within the water. So that is the commercial systems for the crystal dosing. If you have any further questions on this or require any further help, please contact us in the usual way.